Yeah.
Right, yeah, so you look great.
Yeah, good. Yeah, so yeah, you asked the question, right?
Right. So, when you first met Kurt, what came to your mind?
Well, it was a blind date. I was home, and a voice on the phone said to me, "I am out of 10. I am an 8.5." And I had never in my life, in all my years of dating, ever heard a guy say that before. So it piqued my interest right away. And then I was going to be teaching on an Air Force base just outside of London. I was to leave in 12 days. I listened to Kurt, and this was a Tuesday night, August the 2nd, and he said, would I go out with him on August the 4th? And I said, oh my goodness, I would have loved to, but the girls were giving me a going-away dinner at Scandia's restaurant up on Sunset Boulevard there in California. But luckily, because I'm Irish, I had the last word, and I said, but I tell you what, I'll meet you afterwards. And that was so wonderful, because otherwise I was going to be scratched off his list of 100 girls' names. If you weren't home, you were scratched off. If you didn't answer the phone, you were scratched off. So goodness sakes, I got the date. We just hit it off pretty nicely from the very beginning. And after 2 days, I told my mom, Mother, I'm not going to go teach on that Air Force base. I want to stay here. I really want to fight for Kurt. And she, oh, Kathy, it's another one of your infatuations. And my mom used to say, why don't you just have a little card printed out with your name and telephone number? Just hand those out to all the boys. You just are so silly. I said, no, Mom, this is special. And sure enough, I fought for him. I had to fight off Nancy Sinatra. I had to fight off a lot of those people on the hunt that were listed in that 100 names. And he went on the dating game. The night dating game, where if you are chosen, or he was going to go, but I wouldn't let him because I knew he'd be chosen and he'd go off to some land in Europe somewhere. So I made him go on the daytime one. And he didn't like the girl that he went on time anyway. But we have had the most fun and different experiences for all these 46 years. And I was pretty helpful in helping him with his office, meeting people, bringing people in. I've kind of been, like he always likes to say, I'm his neon light. That I'm kind of what shines and lets people know, you know, what the surgery that he does. And he's such a kind man, and that's why he gets so many patients and why he had so many, because he listens. Lots of doctors today don't take the time to listen. And Kurt always does. He will be there. He will listen. Whatever kinds of problems, he's there to listen.
Oh, that's great. Now, so for the first date, what was your impression of him?
Oh, when the door opened and I saw him, I was aghast. My mouth stayed open for about 3 seconds. I thought, oh my goodness, he had told me. He wasn't
8.5.
Super tall. No, he had said he wasn't super tall. He was going a tiny bit bald. But, oh my goodness, I can still remember he was wearing a white sweater and these black and white checked pants, and he was so handsome and just so adorable, and I was just thrilled and delighted with the way he looked. And I still have the outfit that I wore the day, that same night when I met him, and he can tell you down to the shoes what I was wearing, and it was magical, very magical.
But he did say something about your eyes.
Now remember, I am a school teacher in our Watts area, which is our black area. I had 45 little black children, first graders, so they were 6 years old. He tells me after he first meets me, he says, oh, Kathleen, you're so lovely, but do you know you have congenital blepharochialosis? Now, I had no clue what that was. As a teacher, first grade, where I was, living in California, not much knowledge of plastic surgery. I thought it might be cancer that I wouldn't live through the night. I had absolutely no idea. So eventually explained that it's fatty tissue up here. And like in a chicken, there's a little yellow fat that's in a chicken. That's what he said I had in the tops of my eyes. So a month later, he went ahead and fixed my eyes. And when my mom came to visit, I was all black and blue. I'm Irish, so I get black and blue anyway. Oh my God, she was on the floor. And she said, what did we let this man do to you? Oh, Kathleen, I'm so sorry. And I said, but Mommy, it doesn't hurt. It's okay. And I was back to teaching school after 3 days. So no problem, no anything. It was marvelous. And I liked it because I never could put my eyeliner. Always ended up on the top of my eyebrows. So this way, now I had these nicer eyes. And it was easier to put the makeup. And you know what? You look younger and nicer when your eyes aren't all baggy, and I could see better. So that was the beginning. I've had many, many surgeries since, but that could be an hour-long program. I have had a lot done.
Is there a story that would really let us know what it's like to live with a special guy like Kurt?
It's a little tough. I've got to think on that a minute. He's just done so many surgeries on people who couldn't always afford to have things done. Mm-hmm. He helped to change their lives. I can tell you one that's special. There was a young girl that came out from New Jersey. She was 17 years old, and once you have your first menstruation, you can have your nose done. Her father had found out who was the best plastic surgeon in the California area. And my Curtie's name was given. And the mother's and the little girl had a nose that looked like a horse. She was so, so unattractive. And she told Kurt, it's so sad for me. I wanted to be a cheerleader. I wanted to do so many things, and I'm not popular in school. And my life really sucks there in school. And so she came in, got ready to do the surgery, and that day I was in the office. I don't like to be around too much because I don't think the patients like to see the wife. They sort of want to flirt with their plastic surgeons, and they don't want the wife around, so I wasn't there much. This day I was filling in, and I was this mother had asked, after you've done my daughter's nose, may I come and look? Because as soon as it's done, before the swelling comes, you can pretty well tell what it's going to look like. So my job was to take the mom on in. So when I took her in, she just stood there, tears rolling down her eyes, and she said, I always dreamed my daughter's nose would look like that. And here's the best part. After about a year, they came back to visit, and she told Kurt, I am now the head cheerleader. I was prom queen. I was this. I was that. I get the chills right. He had totally changed this girl's life just by that one little act of fixing that nose that fit the face.